keep going. Okay, stop pedaling, feel the bike move under you. Mm. It's harder control when you're not pedaling, isn't it? Mm. Can you see that? Okay, good boy, keep going now. For that little toe, aim for that little toe. Space. Remember, you know where you turned like you did up there. Come to the left, and then keep turning. Okay. Two by a bit. A bit more space there. So, and then back for the same. This time I'm going to put the cones closer together. All right. Ready? Take us. This will be a bit of an optical illusion for you. Good, Neil, look where you want to go, keep pedaling, you must keep pedaling. Okay, Neil, about every 20 seconds, I want you to look over your shoulder. Good. Why are you doing that? Okay, so anything to be... That's it, good. Okay, keep going. I want you to stop your front wheel as close as you can to the middle cone. Front wheel to the middle cone. Front wheel to the middle cone. Go on, a bit further. Oh, that's pretty good. Now that's not a bad alignment. So can you see how the optical illusion works?
Yeah.
Everyone thinks the cones all aligned. They're not. Okay.
No.
That brought you right. What did that judge there? What was it? What was I testing, do you think?
Stopping distance.
That's stopping distance. That's good. And also the fact that you lined it up correctly. Okay, that's good. Right. Now what we're going to do next is we're going to do a bit of signalling. So this means riding with one hand. Okay. But the first thing I'm going to want you to do is when you're riding along, whichever hand you feel comfortable with, I just want you to take it off, touch your knee, and then take hold of the handle again. But do it slowly. Okay. So watch this. This is the idea.